credit or not, Emma was always a fantastic competitor who was always overshadowed by somebody else. She was always overshadowed by somebody like an up-and-coming star on NXT or somebody she was on the roster with. She was always overshadowed by someone like a Sasha Banks, a Bayley, a Summer Rae even were overshadowing Emma because they didn't seem to know what they were doing with Emma a couple of months ago. But at least now they seem to have a more clear impression for us as to what they want to do with Emma's character. It seems like they are promoting her as a fan favorite, but it seems more to me like they'll turn it around. The more that I think about it, they'll probably turn it around and have Emelina be a heel character, because it seemed like on the last little bit of Emma that we saw there before she was taken off TV and repackaged from Emma into Emelina, they were going about the route of having her be a heel character, which I was impressed by, but they didn't do anything with it, and it went south very quickly, as I just mentioned a few minutes ago. So hopefully when they do a heel character, if that's the way it goes, rather than being a face and a fan favorite, hopefully they will have her be a heel character, and it will benefit her in the long run and eventually put her up in status of being the number one contender or eventually the women's champion on Raw, because it seems like a lot of people are growing very tired of seeing Charlotte losing the title and winning it back within 3 weeks and becoming the John Cena of the women's division. And that's really what Charlotte has become here in 2015, 2016, is the John Cena of the women's division. It seemed like it was Nikki Bella there for a while for both Raw and SmackDown, but now it seems to be more clear that they're making Charlotte into the John Cena of the women's division more so than Nikki Bella, and it seems way to me too much that this feud between Charlotte and Nikki Bella is being refueled and really becoming the center of attention for the women's match Survivor Series, with Nikki Bella being the captain of the SmackDown women's team and Charlotte being the captain, the self-appointed captain as women's champion for the Raw team, teaming up with Nia Jax and Bayley against SmackDown. So it seems like with how much the attention this feud between Nikki Bella and Charlotte being refueled is getting, I think that something else more needs to be given the spotlight in reference to this women's match. So hopefully something will happen for Emma. And this is why I put together this series of videos on Emelina and her upcoming premiere, because I want to see something more promising done for her character, because Emma was always a great wrestler. Her days on NXT proved it, and eventually when she signed with WWE and came into Raw and SmackDown, I mean, she proved that she was a good wrestler, but she was never given an opportunity to tell us really what she was all about and show us what she was capable of as an athlete in a WWE ring. And then she went from being on Raw and SmackDown all the time to appearing on Superstars occasionally, and then she was just giving gimmicks that made no sense to me at all, like being the dance partner of Santina Marella. And as I mentioned here earlier, if you wanted to go that way with Emma, you could have had her be the dance partner of someone like Fandango more so than Summer Rae, because it seemed like Emma was more fitting into being the dance partner of Fandango and having somewhat of a role as a character in WWE that way, rather than just having her be someone who was really a putover individual for women in the women's division who seemed to have more promise at the same time that you were trying to do something with Emma's character. I think there was a lot of confusion with Emma's character. If you ask what my perspective is on Emma, I think there was always a lot of a great deal, if you would, of confusion with Emma's character. One person wanted to do this with Emma, one person wanted to do something else with Emma, probably a third individual of the individuals trying to come up with something for Emma to do wanted to do something else. Probably if it was probably a toss-up, say, between Vince McMahon, Triple H, and Stephanie, they were trying to come up with something for her to do. They couldn't agree what to do with her, so the obvious decision was to take her off TV and have her be repackaged, which obviously is what's being done here with Emma. But to be honest with you, from where I stand, this repackaging of Emma looks fantastic. No matter if she's a fan favorite or a heel, I will accept it either way it goes. I just want to get a clearer indication of who she's going to be feuding with, what her issue is going to be with the women on the Raw Women's Division side of things, if she'll factor in some out of SmackDown storylines with Survivor Series getting closer. As weeks pass by, we are somewhat 19, 18 days away from Survivor Series, so there's a lot of ways it could go, and there is also the chance of her being chosen by SmackDown in the upcoming draft, draft lottery, if you would, by probably 2017 in the fallout of WrestleMania, because always they throw in a draft lottery. So with everybody up for a draft in the draft lottery by 2017, there was a chance she could show up on SmackDown Live. That would be awesome if she could somehow factor into not only Raw storylines, but SmackDown storylines too. And if you're wondering if I am a fan of Emma and Emelina, this repackaging of her character, obviously you should be able to decipher that I'm a huge fan of Emma. I always was a huge fan of Emma. She was always someone who was very appealing to me. She always caught my attention. And I always thought that Emma just had an incredible chance of being something special in WWE, but she was never given that chance by WWE because of the lack of creativity with her character and just how WWE never had that confidence with Emma. So I'm hoping that something will happen for Emma in the way of her being repackaged, and something more credible will happen for her character in WWE. It's just a matter of them trying to figure out what they're going to do with her, and hopefully it'll be something more promising than what we have previously seen from Emma, which really has never amounted to anything, and hopefully people will be writing great reviews about Emma in the fallout of this upcoming premiere. It's just a matter of trying to figure out when, where, and how this premiere will come to be in WWE, and I'm hoping it'll be a feud with someone who's very promising in the way of, say, a Bayley, or somebody who's really not factoring in as of right now to the Women's Championship. Bayley's trying to factor in somehow to feuding with Charlotte over the Raw Women's Championship, so hopefully it'll happen for Emma and happen for Emma very soon. This premiere can't happen soon enough because it will offer a reprieve to wrestling fans, and for the critics out there, let me say this. This will give the critics out there something positive to write about for their column or to post on YouTube in the way of video reviews or radio shows that you're producing about professional wrestling. Hopefully, this will be the first little bit of positivity you can throw the way of the women's division, because we have read so many negative reviews on either women's division for Raw and SmackDown over the years. The SmackDown women's division was always described as a division that would never be on the same level of the Raw women's division in years previous to this one. And now for the first time ever, with the SmackDown women's division creeping up on the Raw women's division, you really got to pick it up on Monday Night Raw, and you couldn't have picked it up a better way than by having a match between Sasha Banks and Charlotte contested inside the Hell in a Cell. So how do you follow that? You follow that with the premiere of Emelina, and I'm looking forward to very promising things happening, a very promising future coming about for Emelina, and I hope I'm not the only one. I really hope I'm not alone with my thoughts in regards to Emelina's premiere, and this is why I put together this YouTube video series on my radio show about Emma's premiere, because I'm really excited to see where we go from here and what will happen next, and I hope you come along for the ride with me. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will talk to you again next week.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
If you want space, if you want change, sleep on your bed, pull it to my head. If you want love, the way that you love. If you want time, I'll tell you no lie. Just
just don't
just don't kill, don't kill the magic. I'm not ready to give up just yet. We can stay until we both forget. So baby, don't kill, don't kill the magic. You can have it, you can have it, you can have it, you can have it, you can have it.
Don't go anywhere. HEW Entertainment Radio will return with the latest news, music, interviews, discussion, and Jonathan Clark next.
When something takes place in the world of professional wrestling, you know where to go. WrestleZone.com. WrestleZone.com. Covering all the latest breaking news daily. Interactive forums where you can chat with thousands of other wrestling fans. Exclusive editorials and audio features by some of today's top wrestling superstars. Exclusive video content, weekly polls, live play-by-play coverage of every WWE and TNA pay-per-view. And now, featuring WrestleZone Radio, live with news, in-depth discussions, debates, and interviews with wrestling's top stars, past and present. When you think wrestling, think WrestleZone. WrestleZone.com.
He considers himself God's gift to wrestling, and millions of his faithful agree. With nearly 4 hours of footage and exclusive commentary and matches, this DVD chronicles Daniel's rise from Chicago's Windy City Wrestling to the Asylum in Nashville, and finally to the top of TNA. TNA Home Video presents Heaven Sent, Hell Bound, the best of Christopher Daniels. Available at most retailers and TNAWrestling.com.
Hey you, right there, the one listening to this show. While you're tuning into this broadcast or when you read the news,